Use your leg muscles. If knees are nice and bent. Next are your hips and your shoulders. You want everything square to the basket. You don't want to have everything turned here, shoulders turn, all kind of different proportions that different players use. Your hips and your shoulders are square. Same goes back to your footwork. Everything's coming up square to the basket when you shoot. Then your elbows in line with the basket. You're not shooting out here, because if I'm out here and I fall through, I'm getting a cross fit of the ball. So my elbow in line, pointing right at the basket. One of the best things you can do to work on your shooting form is when you get home, or at the hotel, just stand in front of the mirror. Get it up to the set position and work on your shot. Watch the shooting line. Take a piece of soap. I love this at the hotel. Take a piece of soap, draw a straight line down the mirror. Stand there in front of it, watch that line. See if your elbow stays in line in the shooting form. If it gets out here, you can tuck it back in under your, the ball so you get it to the basket. So your elbow's in line. Don't want to overcompensate here, keep topping or whatever. Underneath the ball, in a good shooting line. My right toe, I'm a right-hand shooter, right upside my body. My elbow's in line with the basket. Next is my wrists. I want to have a wrinkle in my wrists. Everybody find a wrinkle. If you go to shoot and you don't have a wrinkle here, you're going to get too much arm in the shot. You need to bring it back, cock your wrist, in position so you see some wrinkles. I know you're not as old as I am, but you should still have a few wrinkles in there, no matter how old you are, even the younger kids. So you got to get that wrinkle. When I'm working on my dribbling, I've got my wrinkle here. When I get ready to pass, I've got my wrinkle there. When I shoot, I want that wrinkle. I don't want to get it, so where I'm dribbling, I'm here. I don't have a wrinkle, I bring it up. You gotta bring it back, now to get the wrinkle, and shoot. When you shoot, it's a one smooth motion, a one step shot. So that I'm ready to shoot right now as I've got the ball. You can see I've got the wrinkle in my wrist. Ball's up on the fingertips, the pads. Not overextended up here. It's just sitting in your hand. It's got some room in there, it's not down on my heel. It gets on your heel, see what happens to your wrist again, you lose that wrinkle. So you move it up into the fingertips, wrinkle on the wrist. As you shoot, you extend your arm, extend your body, point right at the basket. Now, a lot of you guys, as you shoot, want to throw curveballs. You can turn your wrist that way, or you can turn it outside. You shoot, you reach down for the floor. You shoot, you follow through up to the ceiling. Every time you should be shooting at the basket, almost like you put your hand right on top of the basket. You cover it after it goes in so it won't pop out. Most guys, one of the biggest problems they have, obviously, is they really squeeze the ball here and bring it down to the floor. You kind of hump that wrist. Instead, you want to pop it so you get a good rotation of the ball, point it at the basket. My left hand, all it does is help balance the ball on the way up, get out of the way. Up. Out of the way. I don't want to go up and play defense on myself. We had a kid in my high school team used to do that. You go up and shoot every time after the release. Figure out why he couldn't see the basket. Some of you younger players also will have a tendency to get that left thumb involved. When you do that, you get cross spin. You don't want any cross spin involved. You want good back spin. So if it's not dead center, it'll fall through. So it's here, just on the side of the ball, not on top, not underneath, kind of off to the side. Help with a good balance, carrying it up, and shoot to the basket. Now, let's talk about our tournament shot. Everybody make a circle here. If you look, I get to punch you twice on the arm, but now that game's up. This is the basket. Hold it eye level. Can you see in the basket? Not very well, can you? Well, that's a shot with no arch, or very little arch, a flat shot. It doesn't have much chance going to the basket. Okay, now lower it. Okay, that's a shot that has good arch on the ball. Look at all the opportunities it has to go in there. So if you're not exactly dead center, it still has a good possibility of going in the back. Talk about the geometry, all those fun kind of things. Learn in school, the angles. Basketball's a game of angles. Now, I'll go in and shoot with you. I'm old, have warmed up, early in the morning, got all kinds of excuses. But watch my form. Don't necessarily watch when the ball goes in. Hopefully it will. But watch the form just to kind of get an idea of what it should look like. Watch, start from the feet all the way up here. And then as you warm up, can work your way back now. Notice now that I start backing up, I get my feet set as I see a pass coming. Step into the shot, follow through. Left hand is out of the way, knees nice and bent. Elbow in, follow through. Back spinning the ball. Try not to hit the rim, good arch. Over the front of the rim, every time falling in. Gonna work my rim. Work. Got a break there, good back spin. About 2 minutes, Alan. Now, I know from my practice, when I miss a shot normally, I overcompensate this way. I don't throw many curveballs, but I'm in cycle outside. Okay? So those things out of the court. I want to keep my feet in line of the basket, knees bent, elbow in, follow through right at it. Same thing as I'm dribbling now. As I said, you can't always catch the ball and be facing the basket. If you want an inside foot plant, square up, follow through. Basketball's a great game. I get to come out here and shoot around all morning and see a real one. You do this all day long. Yeah, if people invite me to come over here, I still do it. America's a great place. Doing up there, the more you make, you're going to start getting a lot more confident. That's a big key for yourself, too. Thinking you can make those free throws. Not worrying about what happens if I miss. Concentrate on putting the ball in the basket. 85-90% right up here in the brain. The other 10-15% is what we just talked about, the shooting form. Everybody know about the nail hole in the free throw line. Anybody doesn't know? You young guys know about the nail hole? Okay. There's a hole right here. It's in every free throw line. When they draw this circle, they take a hammer and a nail, stick it in there, a piece of string, and measure it out to here, and walk it around. So when they take that nail out, there's a hole. And that'll tell you right where the middle of the free throw line is. Without even looking, I can tell you this is the middle right here. Okay? So I'm a right-handed shooter. I said I want everything in the right line. I'm going to put my right big toe on that hole. My old routine used to be when I played, I'd bend down and grab my socks. It's a little tough to get down that far too often. Grab my socks, drop my hands off before the referee would give me the ball, take the ball from the set dribble, get to the set position, take a deep breath, help me relax, fall through. Again, just a routine every time. Notice when I make my first shot, I don't step off the line. I've got a good spot, feel comfortable there. I'll go ahead and shoot. Now if I miss my first shot, I'll back off and start my routine again. 85-90%, pop, good concentration. Another 10-15% form of work on. Now, even though I'm not playing anymore, what I used to do, let's speak to a camp, let the camp try to make as much noise as it can so I can work on my routine, my concentration, trying to help me block those. Block out all the things going on, so if you want to make as much noise, go right ahead.
Get back to the shot.
When you shoot, you find it always rattles around, comes out. You don't know how to use backboard when you shoot. But it goes far. Ball seems to be rattling around quite a bit coming out. You may be shooting a little too flat. You may not be giving enough backspin to the ball. So if you shoot enough ball up there, the ball doesn't rotate. It doesn't have as much spin. It won't catch itself and come to pull itself down in through the hole. Maybe try to arc it a little bit. Remember the old circuit drill. Y'all love to get punched twice more. A flat shot, you can't see any basket very good. Good arc shot, good opportunity to fall through. All right, passing. Let's talk a little bit about passing. Yep. All right. Nowadays, I watch games. It's amazing how many guys pass. How many guys pass in the passing lane? Because we're not good passes. Passes where your arms can reach, just like guys sticking their hand out, you might be able to stop. Okay? You put it down where you can't reach it. You have a guy light up, and all they gotta do is deliver the ball on the passing lane, and arm high up to get your piece out of it, lose the pass. Now, some things to think about when you're trying to make a good pass. First of all, the man's open, my man's here. He's got a pretty good chance of stealing wherever I pass it because I need to take up the slack. Just follow the ball. Okay, I'm gonna make all kind of fakes. He's still got time to react. Now, if I take up the slack, he's up and down. He's got a little. He doesn't have any time. So if your man is off you and you're trying to make a pass, you may have to take a good one through it. There's some different areas of a good passing lane. One, right over the top of the head. Because if I miss, normal reaction, if I miss, that'll take. If I miss, I'm going to start ducking the next time. And it's a word right there. You want to duck, put your hand up from here. Another one maybe to fake and go right by his ear. One more thing. You get one time in the middle of the head, start having a little pussy step over. Okay? Not arm high area. Maybe by the foot, because if it kicks, you'll still get the ball back. You won't get the basket, you'll still get it back. Okay, those are some different areas. You make fakes. Looking away. But you don't want to throw arm high baskets. So there's good length here, here. You can maybe through the leg once in a while. Break my jump on you. This is coming. It's in all there. What was the passing thing? Guy in the low post, if he's a tall guy, he's got a short guy on him. He's got his hand up here, throw it to his hand. That way, if he doesn't get it, it's his fault, not yours. He's up here, you're throwing a bounce pass, the guy comes around and deflects it. You know whose problem that is. The coach says, well, why'd you throw it down there? He's 6'9", 6'8". Give it to him wherever they hold their hand up. Read the target. Get a good angle. If you're trying to throw it low post, you're trying to throw one from here. You may need to flatten out your angle. Got a better position to follow the basket. Defense is on top here, they may be able to steal coming over the top. The key to a good shooter, besides the shooting form, is passing. You gotta have somebody on the team to get your ball every time they're rolling. Or most of the time they're rolling. And when they get your ball, they get it to you so that when you're open, you catch it, and you're ready to shoot. Not so that when, if you're open, and he throws it, maybe behind here, it throws my balance off, now I've got to readjust myself and make it tougher. Or if he's open, instead of getting the ball right from his shooting position, I throw him a bad bounce pass that throws the steps off, or I make him extend up, and he come down, gather himself, and go back up. You want to get a good pass somewhere in the chest area, shooting position. Y'all know I'm sure about the triple threat position right here. Good pass and shoot. Okay? So good pass. You're a point guard or whatever, you need to get the ball delivered. Good location. Ball handling drills. If you're having trouble whether you're a big man or small man, working on your ball handling. 18,000 different things you can do. Anyone see the Pete Merrick story that was on TV there? Pretty good show, wasn't it? Okay. Talked about when he was an eighth grader, how he played in the high school team, just working on his ball handling, shooting, whatever. into the eighth grader because it's control of the basketball, they kind of slapped one on the team. There's all kinds of different drills you can do on your life and work on, from just the figure eight, or down the leg, down the other leg, figure eight, always keeping your head up. Around the waist, the ankle, the body grab, roll down the back. And you're thinking, I'm not going to be able to use this in game. What's he talking about? Well, you won't use the game probably. Well, there may be this chance of a loose ball and try to get through this. But all it's trying to do is use your hands to use some basketball. But if you tap this over your head by not looking at it, whatever this drill is talking about, try not to lose the ball. So if you see a guy open down court, you get it to him. So you're working whatever, you may be running down the lane. Throw a pass, whatever it may be, in the situation. So it just becomes natural instinct. See a man open, you get the ball to him. You don't hesitate to see who it is. If he's open, he's got the ball. Concept is blood circulating in the hands. Finger tip control. Anybody got any questions on that? Are you guys interested in coming out? Coaches are to come up. Say what, let's do. We'll get two lines, one on each end, and we'll just have to turn on maybe shoot one, shooting for them. If I see something, maybe point out, I'll try to help you get things back in line. Remember, get your line fast, knees bent, hip shoulders down, elbow in, wrinkle the wrist, hand open, relax, bottom foot fast, left hand bounce, and out of the way. Alright?
Out?
Yeah.
No, they can get loose because there's a couple of guys that can get a chance to challenge you in a 3-point contest with a sweatshirt.
Okay.
I know you guys will be a lot of volunteers.
Come on down. Shoot you.